Hello, beautiful people. Today we're gonna play with skellige. It's gonna be an Invigorate. As you know, right now Invigorate is at 15 points of provision, which is a buff. Also, a few of the cards like Itilen got buffed, and obviously Aglaze. So this is a buff. But to be honest with you, this is still for me a deck that should consist only units. And this is definitely a rent-free deck. Plus, obviously, you need to also involve cards as some thinning cards, plus Iris von Everett, plus Iris Companions. And then for me, this deck would make absolutely sense. I will try to create a deck with rent-free. But the only problem that I had this season was that Renfrey got nerfed, and that's why I didn't want to include Renfrey in this deck. But I will do a second version of this deck. This time it will not be a golden necker, and we will try to do something maybe more spicy. So now let me just walk you through the cards and let's discuss the strategy. So we have Invigorate, three leader ticks. In our best case scenario, the option is that we have 10 units in our hand, and 10 of these cards, they are all units. One of the units that you have in your hand is obviously a Farseer. Then you will use two of your leader charges, and you will boost all of the units except obviously Torque. And then you will play Farseer, and then all the boosts they will go to Torque, so he will be boosted by 8, and he will give 8 points of boost to a different unit. Most preferably it will be Aglaze. What is important for us is to have in round 1 and automatically boost units such as Torque. Obviously it will be in our hand from the very beginning, but what is important is to have Aglaze, is to have Sheldon. And that would be pretty much it, because the other cards are not that boost dependent. So now let me just walk you through the cards and what's the story behind this. Here you have a card scroll. Just in case you have some kind of a problem with the cards, then you still use this option. In our case, what is important is to obviously have as many units as it is possible in round 1, Farseer, but also what is important is to have Aglaze. That's why you I also included here Tris Butterfly, and then you can exchange, let me say, one of the special cards or locations into one of the units. Necker, this is our thinning. Just make sure that you have you don't need to worry about the units, but you need to worry about the special cards and also about the locations. And what is important is to you need to have a certain card for certain situation. So Royal Decree, this is important. This is a card that can give us, for instance, Siri Nova. If it's played in the first or the second round, it will play for 9 points of provision for 16 points, which is pretty amazing. Unfortunately, if we don't draw her in the first or the second round, then she is pretty much useless. Jovert, he will be played into the only trap that we have here, and it's going to be a sticky situation. And the sticky situation is that it's going to be played in a different way. So it's going to be played in a way that we're going to boost it automatically. So we will use the spring, and then it will use by 6 our Torque. Then you would like to play Jovert, and once again do the same, and once again replay the sticky situation. Itilen, just make sure that you will play her in this way, that you will have still 3 cards in your hand. Then you will play Itilen, you will boost Torque, and Torque will boost automatically Aglaze. Tris Butterfly, this is our consistency, and this is important. Aglaze, this is basically and pretty much our last say in the game. Why is that? Because you have some kind of cards that are boosting the cards in our hand, but also once you will drop a Torque, then you will still get boosted, and basically all the boosts will be doubled, if you know what I mean. So it's not that important to play Torque as the last card, unless the it is like really high, but it would be so much better to play a glazed as the last say. Sticky situation already discussed. Sheldon already, I would say, pretty much discussed. Also, we need to have him in round one. The bigger the better, obviously, to a certain point. We need to be focused on Sheldon, but to a certain degree. There is no point of having Sheldon like at, let me say, 30 points, because I don't think that opponent will have a unit like this. Idaran here, he's mainly for one card, and obviously this card is gonna be a Hawker Smuggler, plus not only Hawker Smuggler, but also the Megascopes. And Megascopes, they are purely here, obviously, for Hawker Smugglers, and also the same situation goes for Idaran. So make sure you will play Idaran in a melee role, plus the Megascopes, and by doing this, you can create a crazy value by multiplying multiplying this card. Torque, it doesn't have to be the last say, it can be the second card from the end. Dunka, make sure to play her early, because this is important for us to get the boost ASAP. Our control option is gonna be a Ciaran and Moren. We cannot depend on cards like obviously Heatwave, because this is 10 points of provision. We also cannot depend on other cards like Curse of Corruption, because we are the one who is having the super huge units. So we need to focus pretty much on logs. Hawker Smuggler, important card for us. I would say that there is still no point of having Hawker at 6 points of provision. For me, this is the problem of this entire deck. This card should be at 5 points of provision, and then it would make absolute sense, especially if you right now think about cards like Fallen Knight, which is at 5 at 5. Plus it gets boosted every single time when the unit is created on the on your side of the battlefield. Then it means that obviously Hawker, I mean, there is no point of this guy being at 6 points of provision. It would make have sense, but if you could target the boost in a specific way, so basically you would be the one who is targeting the boost. If it's random, then it means that 6 is still too high, although it got boosted by 5, but it's still not good. Circle of Life, in my opinion, this is the only deck that should play Circle of Life, because I mean, you are dealing only 3 points of damage, which is not too much. It can only be good with the hand buff. Other than this, in my opinion, 3 it's not enough. I mean, you're starting with 4, and then you can think about something like this. Teleportation, here we have this card only to replay Hawker support. Hawker support means 3 points of boost. If we're gonna obviously boost Torque, it means additionally 3 points. So this is a crazy value, and just imagine that you can replay this card twice by using 2 of the teleports. Guys, what's my opinion? Although hand buff got buffed this season, it's still not a competitive deck. It is still missing its value, especially right now if we have Renfrey at 15 points of provision. This is, I would say, like a big hit in Invigorate, because I cannot imagine Invigorate without Renfrey. And Renfrey at 14, it is too much. Although, I tried to create something different, but the problem is that at 15 points of provision, Invigorate, it's still not good. This deck, since it's missing some of control options, it needs to be at least 16 points of provision. And then, definitely, plus Renfrey at 14, we would have these 2 points of provision, which are pretty crucial for this deck. And then we could do something maybe a little bit different. This thing that you see over here, it's pretty optimal. If we had additional points of provision, what I would change in this deck would be definitely one of these logs, and then we could look for a card that would benefit our deck in some kind of a way. Definitely we wouldn't play Aguara, maybe something different, but as far as you can see, you know, it doesn't work. Maybe it could be knickers for consistency or something like this. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your time and support. Please like, subscribe, and comment, guys. See you in the next video. And the last announcement, please go to the nearest shelter and adopt a dog. Thank you very much, guys. Bye-bye.
Keep a stiff neck.
Second Sodden. Though trees live longer than humans, they need protection from them.
Not afraid? You should be.
Take enough berries and take like an arrow to the head instead.
Hey there! Come here!
Surprise, just for you, love.
The only good human is a dead.
yes, and he won't let us talk to strangers.
Wind, blow out the flame!
Oh, don't dare cross me, or my friend here will take
you. Coin or sodder.
Dry and lay!
Only one with no sense would trust the word of a swan.
In one dance, Dunderheat!
Nine is the time of the sword and axe.
Humans have no right to make such a claim.
Becker, Becker, boom!
Drink this, you'll feel better.
Let's get this over with.
Here is a diversion for my pleasure alone.
Choose! Dare not mock mine!
I'll do what I can.
Estead, va!
Are a serious matter to be undertaken proudly with grace.
Already.
Estead, va!
When Raffard would see us dissolved!
Just for you, love.
You've met your match, puppet.
You'll regret your mum ever squirted you out.
Folks say we live like princesses. If only they knew!
Nigh is the time of the sword and axe.
As you wish, my lady.
Carefully, lest this semester be your last.
Shall your armor deflect?
The only good dwarf is a dead dwarf.
Mother will be proud.
Show me the coin or sod off.
Did you see that? Anything alive would be dead now. Killer spell.
Business for me.
An ill wind blows.
They'll not leave here alive.
Nice! us! Bedrai, Enlai!
You heard about Tridam Ultimatum?
Fine! If my coin's ranked to ye, go kiss a dog nicked its tail. Oi! Hey there! Come here! Your mum ever squirted you out.
Your blood smells sweet.
You'll feel better.
Humans have no right to make such a claim.
Just for you, love.
So sweet.
I will not let this become a second Sodom.
Lost spirit devoid of name, depart now our veil of pain.
When the white frost comes, do not eat the yellow snow.
You taught